I was going to make the first video on this channel about terror management theory. Ernest Becker's idea that all facets of society, belief in legacy, belief in the ego, self-esteem, any attempt to extend yourself past your physical form or the time you exist in, culminates from a fear of death and a fear of the finality of death. Which really interests me because I think that the Western world, compared to anywhere else at any other time, is just god-awful at talking about death. It's completely hush-hush, especially with the older generation right now. It seems the what you'd call boomers. They don't want to talk about dying. Terror management theory was on my mind a lot because I was thinking about how I was thinking specifically about like a source fear. Like a singular fear that fuels anxiety, social anxiety, keeps you from making risky decisions, is the source of fear, the fear of death. And that's what terror management theory touches on. And the reason I say I was going to make a video on terror management theory is because I've recently thought of a new angle that's kind of almost more terrifying. Because the thing with terror management theory is I believe we can learn to accept death. And many societies and cultures and people have done that and moved on. But I don't think death is the source fear. What I think is another source of fear is you can never in any possible way communicate to somebody an idea effectively enough that they understand it on the same level that you do. Nobody will ever really know you like you know yourself. We live in our own heads. Consciousness is inward. We all believe that we're special, that we have something to offer the world. Our ideas are nuanced and endlessly complex and beneficial, and we can do something. Having an idea that makes the world a better place, you know? Because I'm not talking about like the desire for a legacy. I'm talking about like, in the sense of pure virtue, you want to put something out into the world that does good, but you also live with the knowledge that like, you may never be able to communicate effectively. Scale it down to arguing with a partner, you may never ever communicate your point, and you may come across as irrational or toxic or abusive or verbally abusive. Most people aren't malicious. Most people aren't nefarious. They either want to save their own skin or just communicate their point or try to find a middle ground, try to find some sort of rationality to move forward. I genuinely think most people operate like that. I have a lot of hope and optimism for just how good people can be. It doesn't matter. Language is so inherently flawed. You just can't communicate. And that's why when you read philosophy, it's so endlessly nuanced, and the sentences and every word is like almost perfect. There's nothing accidental. There's nothing automatic. There's no filler. Every single word has intention, because if it doesn't, the point can be lost on what said author is trying to say. And I think that's a really great example of how far language can go to explain a point, and even still, you don't know if you got what they were saying. And you never will. Because two people can never communicate effectively. And it's the fear of public speaking. And it's the fear, it's what fuels social anxiety, is that no one will understand you. I fully believe in God, but it's just, I don't want to explain it because it's, there's no point. No one will get it. No one will get it the way I get it. You know, this whole idea of a singularity of consciousness. I'm not going to touch on that yet. That's a later video. More schizo stuff coming down the chute. We can't communicate. We just like blanketly can't communicate the kind of lack of language that you have when you think of a concept. Like when you're visualizing a concept and there's no symbol tied to it. There's no sentence. There's no explanation. But you grasp it. You just have an understanding of the knowledge. No one will get that. And you can't give that to anybody else. And that's that. You know, once we swallow these pills, we can go forward in the framework that we need to go forward in. Nobody will ever really know who you are. And you'll never really know anybody else. And every relationship is superficial. God bless. Next time, I'm gonna talk about trickle-down ideas.